to make you understand the concept of potential difference, I'll have to take you into the physics of class 11th and class 12th. But I'll have to do it in a very, very shortcut manner. Okay. So let me first tell you work energy theorem. Work energy theorem. Okay. What does it say? It says that any work that we do on an object, gets stored, in it in the form of
potential energy.
Potential energy or kinetic energy or both. Fine. Potential energy, kinetic energy or both. Now, what is work? That you already know. Work is force into displacement. Is it not? This is force. This is displacement. Okay. Now, there is the concept of electric field. So I straightway jump to that. Fine. And show it by, I'm showing the electric fields by these parallel lines. So E, this is my electric field. Okay? This I denote by E. Okay? Now, if I have a charge Q in it, okay? And this charge is a positive charge, say I have plus Q, then this charge experiences a force in the direction of electric field, and the magnitude of this force is actually equal to Q into E. I'm jumping into so many things, but I'll make you understand. So what happens? A positive charge Q plus Q in the field experiences a force F is equal to QE in the same direction as the electric field. Okay. A negative charge minus Q in the field experiences a force F is equal to minus QE in the opposite direction to the electric field. okay? So if I have a negative charge, say an electron here, then it will experience a force, say it is minus Q, then it will go in this direction.
There are concepts of vectors and whatnot involved in this, but at this level, just try to hold these things in mind. Fine.
Now, if I want to take this charge from a point A to a point B here.
So I am trying to take this plus Q from point A to point B. Now what is happening? This charge is experiencing a force in this direction. So if it is left, it will tend to come in my direction. So to take it from A to B, I'll have to push it by a force that is slightly greater than QE. Correct?
Now, in order to move the charge plus Q from A to B, an external agency, which is me in this case, I am the external agency, has to do work. See, what will happen? I'll be pushing it in this direction. So this is my force external. Okay, this is F E X T external. And where is the displacement? What is the direction of displacement? It is also in this direction. So X is my displacement. Okay. So in order to move the charge plus Q from A to B, an external agency has to do work. W, where W is equal to F into, if the distance is S, then S.
So who has done the work? I have done the work. Now the work energy theorem says, if I do the work, it gets stored inside the system as potential energy. And what I do? I take care not to accelerate this system. Okay, you just know this much. Otherwise, if I start telling more, then perhaps you will get confused. So what I do, I push it so very slowly that none of the work that I do gets converted into the kinetic energy. So everything gets converted into potential energy, right?
Now, we move plus Q so slowly that it doesn't attain any perceptible velocity, so that all the work gets converted into the potential energy, and none into kinetic energy, and none into kinetic energy.
Correct? We understand that? Now what happens? So since I have done the work, what happens? The energy,
the potential energy at B becomes greater than the potential energy at A. Since work has been done by the external energy agency, since work has been done by the external agency, the energy at B is greater than the energy at A. How? By work energy theorem. By work energy theorem. Is it not?
So there is a potential energy difference between A and B. Okay?
Thus we have a potential energy difference between A and B.
Okay? There is a potential energy difference between A and B. Now what happens if I leave the charge from B? If I leave the positive charge from B and I know that since it is positive, its force is in this direction that we have already discussed, it will move from B to A. Fine? So have you written this? Or I'll leave it. I'll write it here.
If we leave plus Q at B, it will move from B to A.
It'll move from B to A.
That is, from the point of higher potential energy, higher PE, to the lower PE.
Okay? Now the same kind of thing happens with the charge minus Q. Okay,
on minus Q, say I call this point C and I call this point D.
You have written this? So I'll only modify this, fine? Instead of writing it afresh, I'll just modify this. So now I'm discussing things about minus Q. You first write this, then I'll change it. You have written?
Yes.
Fine. Now I say, in order to move the charge, I'll make the changes with red, minus Q from C to D, an external agency has to do the work F into S, C to D. Why? Because the electric field is pulling me in this direction. So if I want to move it from C to D, then I'll have to apply a force in this direction, which is opposite to the direction in which the system is pulling me. Okay? We move
minus q so slowly that it doesn't attain any perceptible velocity, so that all the work gets converted into the potential energy, none into kinetic energy. This still holds. Since work has been done by the external energy agency, the energy at D is greater than the energy at C by work energy theorem. Thus, we have a potential energy difference between D and C. We understand? If we leave minus Q at B, it will move where? Since the force, if I leave this at D, it will move from D to C. Why? Because the force is in that direction. That is from the point of higher PE to a point of lower PE. So this holds for both the charges. So charges tend to move from a point of higher PE to a lower PE, whether they are positively charged or negatively charged. Right? This we should keep in mind. Now what happens is this. Now I had been moving a charge that was Q. If instead of Q, I was moving a plus 1 Coulomb charge. Okay? If I was moving a plus 1 Coulomb of charge, then what happens? So I'll write it here. I'll erase this. Okay? If instead of plus Q or minus Q charge, we move a plus 1 Coulomb of charge, then the potential energy begins to be called potential, and potential energy difference begins to be called potential difference. Correct? So what do we say? We were earlier saying that charges move from a higher potential energy to the lower potential energy. Now if 1 Coulomb of charge is moving, we say it is moving from higher potential to lower potential. Thus, when a unit charge is involved, we say that charges, when positive unit charge is involved, we say that that charge moves from a higher potential to the lower potential, from a higher potential to a lower potential. Okay? We'll see next.